Another important facet is investor sentiment. Earlier we spoke to Sunil Gudwani, the head of Religare, to find out how he was seeing things pan out as concerns about inflation and the stock markets persist. How are the saving and investment strategies changing in the context of that?
I think, you know, in any emerging economy, there is going to be headwinds. Let's be very clear on that. We'll never have always tailwinds and we carry on flying smoothly. There are going to be headwinds. It's part of the growth. But I think these headwinds sort of give us a reading that we are on the right track. Everything is going too smoothly. There are also going to be issues. The consumer confidence is up. Our sense is, being retail brokerage house, in dealing with M&As all across the country, we feel there's a strong, very strong positive consumer confidence. I don't think that's an issue. I think there is an issue of what the inward remittance coming in, the FIs look at it, on all these issues that have come up, political issues, the bribery issues, all these issues that have crept up in the last couple of months, that's taken sort of the sheen away from some of the issues. But I think in a country like ours, we have a way to get over these things.
Again, I'll break it down into the confidence and the sentiment of retail investors and the corporate investors. Retail investors, you think they are coming back to the markets, they feel that that's again going to be an investment instrument that they can rely on?
You know, the data came out a few days back that there's a global, the household savings rate has gone up nearly 30-35%, which is huge. I mean, compared to visiting developing economies. Out of that 35%, sub 10% gets invested in equity markets. I think numbers more like single digits, 5 or 6%. So there's a huge room for growth. There's a total non-penetration of the product. But this time you have to complement the retail. I think the retail market has been very intelligent. The retail investors normally always get caught with the stock towards the end when the FIs have come and run it up. They have come in and played very intelligently. They have invested intelligently. They have not leveraged the way it should be. So if you look at all the books that are, you know, the capital market funding books, the leverage books, they are not aggressive. They are not there. The people are not taking chances, which is a very positive sign. It is showing a maturity of a retail investor coming into play. When that happens, naturally he is going to take his time getting invested.
But is the largest share of his saving going into equities or market related instruments?
I think it has to. I don't know if it is. There's no data to substantiate that.
Do you see an increase?
Would you
hazard a guess on that?
The inflation. I mean, the inflation is also a product of an emerging market or developing economy. If inflation is going to be 8-9% and the depositors are just going to pay substandard, that they have to invest their money to make money on what they're saving. So it has to come into equity markets. I think with the governance standards improving, with things getting better the way it is, the mood getting better, people are going to divert more and more of the income into the equity markets, maybe to direct equity, maybe through insurance, taking insurance and that funds being invested into ULIPs or whatever. So there is going to be inflow. I don't think there's any dispute on that.